Mozzarella, Naza, Laona, Tabaona. ¡Eh! Zoom bekijkt me.
This interview will be known as Statement 483. The subject is Juliana Da Costa, born in Dili and current resident of Malbisi. Tetun, Mumbai, Portuguese and English speaker, widow, four dependent children. Dona Juliana, hani na rin Paolo. Harono o interes hani tama husi dog.
Si.
Ame kaderes hindi na presensi hani no kolia ko ami. Fa favor, tu lai.
Briada. Sinsa, sala kasak.
Fa favor. Molo kite komesa. Ha karak etete kata how comprende tividade ne laos fácil baita no how respete te tedes te ne brani o di colie te ne storia de be unico no importante laos
sì
Juliana sì. Most of today we've been assembling information with regards to the events of December the 7th 1975. And I note here that you were in Dili on that day.
Sì. How's it in Amalo? Loro ne hani aman harukati hauba hani avosir niuma e habairu selu. Ami atu ba fohor amalao e adadere san na kukone.
To ohin loro, how's it out fila ba?
Então, ya hati ni katak invasion atau kontesi ka?
Si. Emo hot hati ni.
Sesar itu an. Escupa hau hau comprende.
Lorong ni, amba foti hani primusira. Amilio husi cidade.
Depois, porteiro nele e taruto e refato em rototo. Ami nine hito e a careta que coanida.
Bafo, ok?
Sim. Nem acabo de plano. Vai ver se ele tá que tem na Dallan e ponte cais nem oi. Se ele cair, tem um anima barco.
Conhece a Mabalo ni Hanaba? Juliana. Juliana. Was there anyone in the crowd that you can identify for us?
Sim. Ia. Emma Manid. Amen.
Se macane.
Señor Geist, Roger. Hani aman. Irean, emane laran la meeting ona.
La meeting?
pa buat nebe ni haretiona. Tempo ne ba halalun comprende buat nebe hani aman kolia. Now I understand.
McGuire came by. He wants you to meet him at the Darwin Hotel for lunch.
All right.
And there's a man here to meet you. He's been waiting since before we opened.
That bloke?
Yes.
Who is he?
Jose Ramos Horta. I think that's what he said.
Would you give me a glass of water and some aspirin? Tell him I'm busy.
Look at them. Two pieces of shit in matching shirts. This is not the only thing they have in common. Those look very tasty. I will steal two. I will steal two of these. I take one. Okay, one.
Like my secretary told you, I'm busy.
No, I see you're very, very busy. But I've come a long way to find you. Roger East.
Disappointed?
My name is Jose Ramos Horta. I am the East Timor Fretilin Government Secretary of Foreign Affairs. I have a proposition for you.
Here. You look like you could use a real feed. Come on, then.
So this is where you plan to write your memoirs?
Yeah, if I could remember any of them.
You know, Roger, I have read much of your work.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I particularly enjoyed your condemnations of Kissinger and his kind.
Mm-hmm.
The coverage of the U.S. civil rights movement was not too bad. Very good. From Johannesburg, you wrote about
rugby and cricket.
And apartheid.
I well read. I was in the Navy up until 1944. In the
discharge me.
Uh-oh.
You know what for?
What?
Psychotic tendencies.
What? You're going to kill me in my sleep.
Nah, you're safe.
Roger.
Please allow me to speak to you openly.
All right. Far away.
These things you are writing now, the work you do, is bullshit. You wrote with passion, huh? With fire, about important things that matter to the world. I am offering you, on behalf of my government, a position as the head of our news agency. The boss. Full access to my country, to my people, to tell our story.
Run by the government?
No. Aetna, the East Timor news agency, is completely independent.
There is no such thing, my friend.
No, perhaps not, but that is where you come in.
And I come in anywhere.
Hi, Roger. Roger. My country has very, very little time. Please consider this simple proposition, if only for tonight.
While Indonesia denies any plans to claim this nation as its own, the Fretman government in Dili believes otherwise.
No.
Fretman troops are preparing to defend Balibo from this 300-year-old Portuguese fort.
No, Fernando, no! How denki fila!
With nearby seas rich with oil and gas, the question is, how long will it be before other nations act?
Okay, I have to go.
This is Tony Minetti for ABC Television.
Thank you for your good company and a place to spend the night.
Hey, wait a minute, hang on. What's going on? What's happening?
Look, there's only a small window before your country closes down flights to our nation. A few days, perhaps a few hours. Tell the world.
Look, I've retired from that shit.
Right.
Hang on.
You need somebody younger.
Your country already sent young journalists. Five of them.
What are you talking about? What five journalists? What journalists?
These young journalists. Not that your government gives a shit now that they are missing. Take it.
Hi, Roger.
Bye.
Roger Reist. I heard you just got back from Timor. Gonna come in? Well, I'm glad to see that the IBC is taking good care of you since your return. Thanks. So how was it over there? The reason I came to talk to you is because that young chap, Horta, has offered me a job running the East Timor Free Press.
Are you insane?
I wanted to get some information from you.
You don't want to be going in now. The Indonesians are going to invade.
So there are Indonesian warships off the coast?
Yes. And the Indonesians are on the ground. They're not in uniform, so you don't know who to trust. They were shelling every day. We're just sitting in Dili waiting for the invasion, and we didn't know when it was going to come. And why would you want to go?
For the same reason you were there. Did you see any of the journalists from Channel 9 or Channel 7 on your way out?
I saw Shackleton. I told them it was too dangerous. I warned them.
And what'd they say?
Shit together, we leave tomorrow.
Okay, mate.
You're still in bed?
Yes, I am, Malcolm.
See you tomorrow.
I will say no more on the subject of Timor. I'll leave it at that.
But Prime Minister, what is Australia's position on East Timor?
I will not elaborate on the statement I made.
Yeah, hi, Dad, it's Gary. Yeah, I'm good, I'm good. Look, I'm gonna be heading overseas. Oh, not long, probably about a week, too. Oh, I don't know, Dad. Look, all right, okay? Yeah.
There are these five young journalists that have gone missing.
Hello, little man.
Hello, Daddy.
The Australian government is doing bugger all as usual.
Come inside, my man. Good.
They just say they're dead.
Draw me a little picture. Make me a little present. We're going away for us. Okay?
He's got you on the big jobs?
Yes, and tomorrow we head off at 7 in the morning.
It's good for you.
Yeah, I think this is a good one.
Mm.
Just want to go out there, see for myself.
Three cigarettes?
No, I'm sitting this one out, mate.
Smart boy.
Oh. There she is.
So how far ahead is Shackleton, you think?
2 days.
Haven't beat us yet, mate.
Talk to you later.
Welcome to the Hotel Turismo.
Hello, señorita. How are you?
Very good, thank you. What kind of fish is that?
Oh, this is fish called coco fish from Black Law River, south of here. They swim up river to breed before heading downstream out to sea. It's a very clever fish, you know?
Would you like to join me in a glass of wine?
No, no.
Please sit down.
Thank you.
Is that your daughter?
Yes, that's Juliana. She's been a great, great help in the hotel.
Yes, I know. I understand that there was some journalists here recently.
Yes, they were sitting where you're sitting, only 3 weeks ago.
Where were they going?
I think they go to Balibo. This is Dili, where we are. And this is Balibo, near the Indonesian border. Ramos Horta arranged it.
Horta?
Yes.
Tony!
No, I appreciate your enthusiasm. No, tonight, really. Okay, tomorrow,
maybe one more.
You enjoy your meal?
Yes, it was excellent.
That's good. Juliana, can you bring the glass in the bottle, please?
Wait a minute. That's for you.
Thank you.
It's an Australian coin. Here, let me teach you. There you go. Keep your thumb straight. And just use your thumb. You just use your thumb to flick it, all right?
Perfect. Well done.
Who's that?
That is the Queen of England.
What's she doing on it?
That's a very good question.
I think your friends left some bag behind.
He will take care
of that.
Okay.
We'll see you soon.
Okay.
Thank you, Minus.
Make sure to
the queue. Right?
Yeah,
rise
it.
Right. Okay. Have fun.
Okay.
Bye. Oh, hey. We're
away. You didn't tell me that you took the first group of journalists up to Valapo.
I didn't?
No.
Oh, well, yes, I arranged for the first group to travel to Balibo.
Ah.
But only if it was safe.
So who drove them?
And my name's Jimenez.
Anything else you forgot to tell me?
No.
Obrigado.
Look, Roger. Look, mango. Our nation's most famous aphrodisiac. Huh?
I think I'm a bit past that, mate.
How are you?
This, Zimenez chap.
Hmm?
Was he with the journalist in Balibo?
He's in Mobara. Half a day's journey.
How do I get there?
Roger, please. It's very dangerous. There's very important work to do in Dili.
How do I get there?
Okay. We make a deal. I will take you to Mobara, okay? I will show you. And then we go back to Dili and you run our news agency. Deal? Okay, Mobara it is.
Very quiet. Some say the sector be served, but there's 50 kilometers away on the border with Indonesia. Guerrilla fighting continues.
Marlborough, Marlborough 2122.
Keep going.
Marlborough, 1212.
So all right. Just watch the radio there.
They are returning from the front lines. Long before a war officially begins, there are front lines to defend. We stay here tonight. Tomorrow we find Ximenez. Roger, this way.
There's martial music in between his words. Is his speech very warlike? Does he talk a lot about fighting?
Yeah, he's talked long time for fighting. Only fighting. And hoping that people will listen to the radio.
And when Fretilin broadcasts, what does Fretilin say?
The Fretilin said, we are not communists.
Yeah. Great. Gary?
Happy.
Right. Happy. Okay, fantastic. Thank you very much, everybody. Obrigado. Obrigado. Say thank you to these people. Obrigado.
What is it?
Indonesian propaganda.
What are they saying?
They say they know an Australian journalist has arrived in Dili. They look forward to slitting his throat when they find him. Okay, good night, Roger.
Very funny. Okay, what were they really saying? Water?
Thank you.
Roger! Good morning!
What's going on, mate?
The Indonesians are advancing. Everyone is retreating to Dili.
Get help!
I found 3 minutes.
Right. I'm gonna talk to him.
I found him. Huh? 10 minutes.
Okay, that's plenty.
No, 5 minutes. Five minutes, because we have to go.
As much as I can have.
Are you right to go now?
Pronto.
Good. All right, jump in. Thanks, Dad.
You speak English?
Yes, he speaks English. I will translate for him.
I'm looking for 5 Australian journalists. Have you seen them?
Harten.
Yes, he knows.
Where?
Hasiran Esfer, Grupo Pemiram Nebe Makatul Hasiran.
He was that driver. He took the group up from Delhi to Balibo. This was 3 weeks ago.
Hey, Balibo. How he? Of Satyarul.
He took them to Balibo. He waited and he waited. They would not come. They would not retreat.
Okay, we have to go. Wait. No. So it's possible that they're still alive, right? Is it possible?
Maybe Guri Mountain.
Okay. I want you to draw me a map.
Roger,
understand?
The Indonesians are invading. We have to go.
A map.
Everyone is retreating.
Please, draw me a map of Balibo.
Atudo.
There is Balibo, Fort Portuguese here, Indonesia attack from here, but first we want to Maliana. There is school mission.
School mission.
School mission.
Mission school.
Para, Itamar. Ba. That's it. Okay.
Okay. How do we get there?
To the mission school.
Yes.
It's impossible. It's impossible, Roger. All of the roads are blocked.
Well, how long would it take to walk there?
To walk? 12, 14 hours journey walking for me. And you're an old man.
And you're a young man. So you set the pace.
Viva!
Let's grab a couple of shots of that, those huts there and see what you can
do. It's the huts.
Nah.
Shackleton. Tony Minatti, ABC. I was hoping we'd run into you.
How'd you know we're here?
It's all over the Indonesian radio. They're not happy we're here, mate. Fretland's preparing to defend Balibo, but I don't like their chances.
That's where we're headed. We're off there. We're going to Balibo.
The Indonesian warships off the coast are choppers circling overhead, mortified.
Did you film them?
No, we didn't have a chance. We had to get out of there in a hurry. Look, Shackleton, it's not worth it. Believe me or don't believe me, but it's just not safe.
Well, outside Balibo, is anywhere else we can film the invasion from?
Let's go, boys.
Can you, can you take this back to Dili Airport for us?
Thanks, mate.
Sure.
go. You got your bathers on, boys?
Welcome.
Greg Stapleton, Channel 7. How are
Padre
you?
Silva.
G'day, Father Gary.
Silva, you're very welcome.
Thank you for having us.
Tony Stewart. Silva, welcome.
Good to meet you. So what's happening here, Father? Where are these people going?
Refugees fleeing from the border.
And you're staying here?
How could I ever leave this?
So here you got a swimming pool.
Yeah, where's that?
Well, it's up the back.
This way?
You're very welcome. Okay.
This way?
Oh, just get the bar.
This way?
Yeah, grab your...
Your finger,
nothing.
Sorry, fellas.
Cheers, mate.
Welcome to Timor.
We got him.
Cheers, man.
So, Channel 7 beat you to it?
Not yet, mate. There's plenty of time to catch him.
Maybe you should just stick around here for a while.
Well, there's no point just sitting around here filming Eddie Fretland walking around.
Where's Shackleton?
The border. That's where the story is. That's where we're going.
No, but Shackleton's crazy.
He's just doing his job.
Yeah, and we can't let him get out of there before we do.
We do have a driver. Jose said he would take us there.
Jose? Porter?
He's some of the soldiers, so we should be... Thank you for your concern, Tony.
Has he said that he'll protect you?
In a sense. Yeah.
In and out. Welcome. In and out. Welcome.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
Huh?
A helicopter?
Yes.
Is it one of yours?
Are you fucking kidding me?
We are, boys.
Yeah, this is Balibor.
Yeah, stay in the car. Let's stay in the car.
Got it, come
here.
Sira Mayusi Nibi.
Sira Mayusi, Australia. Journalist. Esa situación en Bariak.
Hello.
Commandante Sabica.
Greg Shackleton, Channel 7.
Greg, can we get out?
Do you mind if my men get out of the car?
Yeah, please. From Australia?
Yes.
How are you?
Very well.
G'day. Welcome.
How you going, mate? Tony Stewart.
We spoke to Jose Horta.
Yes, I did get the message, but the situation here is very tense.
Okay.
Well, I think that suits us. I think, do you mind if we...
our camera equipment?
Camera equipment.
Yeah, of course. Right. Yeah, I can send some of my shots to help you.
Is there? Cigarette?
Yeah. Are you on one?
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
60-man Fretland Garrison is here, and there are rumours. There are rumours that Indonesian soldiers are making their way up the road from Madagade.
Okay. Lutana Fati?
Here it is,
going. Coming.
All right, 3, 2.
The buildings here are deserted and strewn with rubbish, yet the spectacular flowers and flame trees remain. The 60-man Fretland Garrison is here, and there are rumours that Indonesian soldiers are making their way up the road from Madagade. We spoke to one soldier today who believes that a potion given to him by his family...
You all right? Are you shot?
No, my ankle.
You're very graceful. You're okay.
Oh my god. Oh, that was fucking crazy.
Okay.
I wanna go.
Now you want to go back, huh?
Yep.
Yeah, you see how dangerous it is. I told you. You didn't believe me. Okay. We're going to walk. There should be a village about half a kilometer. We walk there. They have a vehicle. We get in the vehicle.
No.
We go back to Delhi. No. We start the news agency.
When I said I wanted to go, I want to go home. I want to go to Australia. I can't do this, man. I told you you need somebody.
You're all right. You're okay. We go back to Delhi. We made a deal.
I'm sorry.
I showed you this. I told you that I would bring you here and that you would run the agency.
I
brought you here.
Do it. I can't do it.
Okay. Yeah. And your journalists?
Somebody else will find out about them.
What about my country? What about what is happening? Huh? What about my country?
It's your problem. It's your problem.
Okay, my problem. My problem. Okay, my problem.
Well, did you happen to notice that a helicopter that tried to kill us was American?
No, I was too busy trying not to get shot.
Well, it was. Supplied by the American government.
Yeah.
And how did the Indonesians pay for such a marvelous machine of war? Pounds, Roger. British money. And how did this very expensive American helicopter find us in the middle of nowhere? Intelligence provided by your Australian government. They know you are here, Roger, because your country told them you are here. Just like they told them about the journalists. Don't you think this would be at the highest levels of security? A war 1 hour away that your government has signed off on, and Australians are in danger.
Right, everyone okay, Tony?
We stay here tonight. It's safe. Safe enough.
Ne mai voha tene itani beala makne. Itania beala. Beala ma la faikne. Fofati, malai bo tira tu. Fofati, malai bo tira tu. Abo, afai kuni ba musu iha tasi.
It's a famous legend, the bird of our country.
Itene la fai kubo tira. Musu hine ba, musu iha tasi ibu, hola barikida. Romaran hila.
Itene la fa kubotne hola bari kini ma hadia itene rai itene nengo mori itene peyala makane itene rai dove ni dene si acontece ua truma ne ma au conta ba imi ba alin on la bari kira o firi katuar o di rona imi le bere haluha.
I let him. Where are you?
Estou harco bem, mas ele mal contato com ele. Ele mal agora me tudo, a mim não se deu nada mal agora.
We want to ask why the Indonesians invaded our country. Why the Portuguese doesn't help us?
We are the three journalists here. We are going to find out why and try and help to find out why. We try very hard to find out some answers for you.
Oh, helele, oh, helele, oh, helele, kanamasti.
Something happened here last night which moved us very deeply. Something so far removed from our experience as Australians, and yet so inextricably interwoven within the atmosphere of this place, that we'll find it very difficult to convey to you. Sitting on woven mats under a thatched roof in a hut with no walls, we were the target of a barrage of questioning from men who know they may die tomorrow and cannot understand why the rest of the world does not care. Why, they ask, are the Indonesians invading us? Why, they ask, if the Indonesians believe that Fretilin is communist, do they not send a delegation to Dili to find out? Why, they ask, are the Australians not helping us? When the Japanese invaded, they did help us. Who, they ask, will pay for the terrible damage to our homes? My main answer was that Australia would not send forces here. That's impossible. However, I said we could ask that this fighting is raised at the United Nations. That was possible. At that, the second in command rose to his feet and exclaimed, "Comrade journaliste." He shook my hand, the rest shook my hand, and we were applauded because we are Australians. That's all they want, for the United Nations to care about what is happening here. The emotion here last night was so strong that we, all three of us, felt we should be able to reach out into the warm night air and touch it. Greg Shackleton from an unnamed village, which we will remember forever, in Portuguese Timor.